Okay, this is now City Hall, Wednesday, 2:30 in the afternoon, July the 4th, 2012. And as my other videos were indicating, this is going to be my conversation with the guy that hung up on me on the phone. And to show you the world how Halifax treats people that are disabled. Hello. Could be better. Anyway, I'm doing a video while I'm talking to you guys. I was talking to the assistant of the mayor upstairs a few minutes ago, like maybe 5 minutes ago. And can you let him know I'm down here? The guy with the wheelchair, he knows who I am. Well, he didn't give me his name, but he hung up on me. So now tell him I'm doing a video. I want a recording of his behavior and why he hung up on me when I was talking to him about accessibility and how they've got a crew down the waterfront blocking the road, blocking the sidewalk for people in wheelchairs. Thank you. Whether he shows up or not, it doesn't matter, because I did a series of videos. I'm putting it all online. It won't be too long before everybody will see how the city of Halifax treats disabled people. It's like that everywhere in the city. It's the whole attitude of the city. The sidewalks are a nightmare. They don't fix anything. You can put in a call and say, like, there's a sidewalk where I live. It's got a big trench going across it, and the sidewalk's not level with the grass, so you can't go around it, and you can't get down the main sidewalk, and you ask them to fix it, it never gets fixed. They don't fix anything. They actually pay somebody to go around and paint white lines around all the holes in the sidewalks everywhere. And it's everywhere. They got the paint marks everywhere. They never get fixed. And the paint wears off with the weather as the seasons go by. Like, why are they paying somebody to mark all the holes, but they don't patch the holes? That doesn't make any sense. And a lot of these sidewalks around here, they patch them and patch them. They need to replace the sidewalks that's in such bad shape. It costs more to keep patching them than it does to fix them properly the first time. I've been in a lot of cities in my life, okay? And Halifax has got to be the worst city when it comes to the way they maintain the roads and sidewalks. Like, you would think that we live in a third world country here, because our sidewalks and roads are really, really bad. I mean, there's huge potholes everywhere. When I try to get off of a sidewalk, the cutouts are never made properly. It's really dangerous. And then when you try to get off the sidewalk, there's big holes in the asphalt. You know, people, you tell them what it's like to be in a wheelchair. If this thing gets caught in one of the holes and flips over, it'll kill me. The weight of the chair will crush me. You know, you can't have wheelchairs wiping out. But it's not like the city can't afford to do proper cutouts at the intersections. And it's not like they don't know how. It just don't. The reason why it's not being done, because nobody cares. You know, all the other disabled people I've met, they all tell the same stories, and they've all given up. They absolutely have given up on the city, because the city doesn't care. And you got a whole bunch of people making a lot of money thinking that they're professionals and, you know, they know what they're talking about. But as soon as you try to point out to them that what they're doing is wrong, they don't want to hear it. That's how ignorant everything is in Halifax.
I spoke with him right now. He's going upstairs. I mentioned to you they got a school up there. So he's tied up in the school.
And how long is he going to be?
He'll probably be an hour.
An hour. And then he's going to head home in an hour, right?
No, you have to make an appointment.
Oh, I don't have to make any appointments.
Okay. That's all I can just tell you.
Oh, I know.
That's the protocol we have in City Hall.
Yeah, like I'm going to make appointments, and I don't make appointments for anything, because I never know if the weather is going to be good enough for me to go out in a wheelchair. I don't use Accessibus because they decided to put cargo truck suspension on their rear ends. They should have independent suspension, but they don't. The driver's got a really comfortable padded seat, independent suspension in the front. The driver is nice and soft and comfortable. You're back up high in the back on a wheelchair. You're being jolted so violently, it kills you with pain. I never use Accessibus because they don't have the sense to put a proper suspension in the back end so all four wheels are independent so the truck's not shaking like this. I mean, even furniture gets hauled around smoother than those Accessibuses.
You did say you called Waterfront Development.
He told you he called them?
Yep.
Like those ignorant people are going to do anything. They think they own the waterfront. The waterfront belongs to the people. And I was on a public street, on a public sidewalk, And they decide to have an event in the parking lot next doors, and some idiot in the city says, oh yeah, you can close the only street that gives you access to the waterfront. That's the only road that connects the waterfront. And it's the only sidewalk coming off of a main road to the waterfront. Right, a water street, the warehouse, that warehouse tavern thing. They actually blocked the only sidewalk. And you can look at a map. There's no other sidewalk in the whole length of the waterfront that goes from the road to the boardwalks that's safe for wheelchairs. And I said to him, now you make me have to go like this through parking lots with a bunch of parked cars, and there's no path for wheelchairs. And that's how I ended up in a wheelchair, because I got run over by a car. So I don't want to be in a parking lot. And every time I go in a parking lot, they can't see you, because you're not walking, and you can't jump out of a way if a car's moving. I told them I shouldn't have to endanger my life. But you know what's even worse? You're at the main street. You look all the way down the long sidewalk. It's all clear. The fence is out of the way. They put a temporary fence up. You get to the very end of it, and they put the fence in the way, so you can't go the last 5 feet to get on the boardwalk. And right at that spot, there's a fire hydrant. And I said, I wonder if the fire department knows you've got a fence right up against the fire hydrant. And it's the only fire hydrant in a quarter mile area. And it's the only road to the waterfront. So if there's ever any emergencies down there for anybody else, the fire trucks, ambulances, nothing can get to the waterfront, because it decided some idiot at the waterfront commission thinks he owns the road. They don't own that road. It's a public street. And they don't own the waterfront either. Actually, the funny thing about all the waterfront in Canada, it belongs to the federal government. It doesn't even belong to the province. All water does. All shoreline does. So it's not the jurisdiction of the Waterfront Commission or anybody. It belongs to the federal government.